My joy knows no bounds. When we have come to worship this holy mountain, which we have named as Ganaraj. Because they can hear you without that. Sometimes the words are not sufficient to hold the outpour of your joy. I come to you as a symbol of your mother. But the first son who was created was Sri Ganesh. And then when the Mother Earth was created as a symbol of motherhood, Sri created many Sri Ganeshas in this universe. In the cosmos, the star which is called as Mangalala Kanta, Mars, is the Ganesh, Sri Ganesh. All these symbols were created for you, the Sahaja Yogis, to recognize them. To recognize all these symbols is easier if you are a realized soul. But we have had so many great realized souls in the past of very high quality.
De très haut niveau.
And they recognized, they found out the symbols of Sri Ganesha long time back. India is the microscopic form of the whole earth, Mother Earth. So in the triangle of Maharashtra, we have got 8 Ganeshas which are manifesting vibrations and were recognized by great saints of Maharashtra. But as you have seen, as a grace of these great saints, especially Maharashtra, has created human beings who have Shraddha as the highest expression of their emotion and mind. Because of that lofty vision in the mind, whenever they see something of this sublime nature, their thoughts go to God. Thanks to the saints of that state, that people have that sensitivity and that kind of a movement. Unfortunately, in the West, where Shraddha is something very superficial, anything like this takes them to something very low, something very dirty, filthy, unholy. Instead of surrendering to the sublime and enjoying the greatness of the sublime, they take to something very carnal, which belongs to the flesh. But still, the people who are living in simple ways in the villages, in the nature, must have realized the importance of this holy mountain. Thousands and thousands, millions of years back, the Mother Earth started producing her Ganesha. It was first a huge ocean where Himalaya stands. Himalaya gradually started coming out of that ocean in a flat way, like a Shivalinga, which is the expression as the manifestation of the animals. They have the brains which are flat in this way. But when the Himalaya started coming out of that sea, the Mother Earth was pushed on sides. And the mother has started giving folds to her sari, you can say.
On peut dire que notre mère, la terre, a commencé à draper les plis de son sari.
You can stand up and start with you better. Now, when that movement started, the sari gave waves of vibrations in such a way that at certain points it rose up to a point, becoming like Sri Ganesh. And it was to begin with a flat, again the same type of the. But then still more folds started coming up much later when human brain started developing its ego. So the whole of that land was pushed up and another land joined it in such a manner that it formed a apex. The superego was pushed in and was brought to the climax. That synchronizes with the human brain because the whole universe is represented in our body as well. Now, the central axis of the Mother Earth acted as the spinal cord. By this happening in the Himalayas, again there was a big push onto all the mountains which were to be created as Sri Ganesh, and they got into their final forms. And the apex was created. So the Mother Earth as Gauri created all these Ganeshas. At the other end of these ranges must be the highest mountain because it is pushed the most. You see, when they pushed it, Himalaya was brought up to a point only. Up to a point it went, and then the waves created Ganesha of a certain height, not too much height. So it was pushed on the right-hand side more. The ego went, you see, expression in Mont Blanc, say, for example. And on the other side, it was created another Ganesha at the other end near Darjeeling.
Also?
No. Okay. It is the expression of the ego.
Ego, yes.
So Sri Ganesh was expressed even in Darjeeling, and you get the same kind of redness on that. I have seen another Sri Ganesh created in Delphi, where they say is the nabhi of the Mother Earth. Also, when Shiva is created, Linga is created, along with him, always there's a Sri Ganesh created, as in Amarnath, where a drop of water falls on a particular area and creates the linga, plus that another drop falls on another side and creates Sri Ganesh, exactly like the face. Now the ocean is the father and the Mother Earth is your mother. But when the Mother Earth becomes a mountain, she is called as the father. The reason is she at that height can catch the father on top of her head as snow or as rain. That is how a mother becomes the father. And so she can perform the complete function of a father and a mother. In that state only Gauri, the daughter of the mountains, conceived Sri Ganesha without the help of the father, immaculate. The purity of the snow is 100%, and that covers the Mother Earth, gives the formation of innocence. All the filth and dirt that goes into the ocean is clarified by the sun, which is also Sri Ganesh, and is brought on top of the hills and mountains to cover it. But to Ganesh, it is a big problem to exist in a country which doesn't worship it. It has no sense of respect. It is always aspired that they should climb over. Very egoistical ambitions of a low level and outward. When you see the mountains like this, the idea that should come into a good human being would be, oh God, I can see you in the sublime form, and how will I conquer my ignorance, how will I climb over my mountain of arrogance to look at you. To an egoistical mind, the mountain is for the joy of the eyes, and the joy, which is really not the joy, but is a kind of a pleasure for them to see. Their ego gets challenged and they want to climb on the mountain that we are higher than you. We had Himalayas for thousands and thousands of years in India. Nobody ever thought of climbing it. When the English came, they started doing it first time. Then the French, Portuguese, Spanish, all of them all did this, and the Indians were looking at them bewildered, what are they doing? Why do they want to climb the mountain? It's better to see them from distance and adore them than to climb over them to die. But this egoistical mind can go further, as in Switzerland it has gone, that they try to ski over these mountains, take the slopes to go down. They go down in any case. And they break their legs. I told one Sahajogi who wanted to come here for skiing, I said, don't go there. It's not allowed by Sahajoga. And he came back with broken legs. So every way, the games are also such that is just a satisfaction of the ego. I can understand small children going over a slide, but big old men moving like this for hours together, they have no other work to do. That shows they have no maturity of any kind. They are still stupid children playing with the snow. By all these doings, what happens? That the holy places become like cemeteries. Imagine, instead of putting flowers on Sri Ganesha, you are putting dead bodies on his body. And while skiing, putting those heart nails into the body of Sri Ganesh.
It's true.
There is no sense of respect. Perhaps we don't respect ourselves. We are not matured enough. The first thing that should happen, that one folds his hands to Sri Ganesh and just sees those things. Just this should happen to all the Sahajogis. So the innocence has to be developed to have that respect. If you are not innocent, you cannot have respect. And in the innocence, you don't think you are the wisest of all and make everybody look like a fool. Nor do you laugh at others and make fun of them. Nor do you play games and put people down. But what I have seen, even coming to Sahajoga, this is the worst part of it. I have seen people who play games after coming to Sahajoga. They gossip and say all kinds of wrong things, which I have never said before. There was so many kinds of things I hear that I'm amazed how Sahajogis are such creators of gossips. Is this the way Ganesha would behave towards the mother? That thinking yourself to be great people, you say mother said so and this happened and that happened. Ego is anti-innocence. And that's why this kind of a nonsensical gossip people do, which I can't understand, so filthy, I just can't understand. Like there was one lady whom nobody would marry. And there was only one fellow who accepted to marry that woman. And that's how the marriage took place. Now this lady, or perhaps somebody who is like her, has spread stories that she was the most beautiful woman. Everybody wanted to marry her. Everybody raised their hands. I never asked people to raise their hands. It's not like that at all. When I heard it, I was shocked. This woman, nobody wanted to marry her. There are all kinds of things that you have got from your past. And you must try to get out of it. Otherwise, you cannot rise high. A person who is not innocent cannot worship Shri Ganesh. In his right hand, he has got a parsha, you must know that. A terrible instrument, you see, with one stroke, he takes out your head like guillotinitis. Those who are not innocent play games, try tricks, gossip, indulge in filth, he cuts them off. Innocence is a very sharp thing. It does not have any compromise, which you can see in the life of Christ. With his drunk, he throws people left and right and throws them out. He sees for a while, and if people remain still half-baked, they are thrown out of Sahaja Yoga. No one should think that you have got realization. You can be in the Sahaja Yoga if you do not take to innocence. Innocence gives you complete sincerity. And Ganesha is the judge, and he is the one who throws you out of the periphery like a tangent. You get out of Sahaja Yoga. And when you get out of Sahaja Yoga, you start going down and down and down, and then you may develop horrible diseases of the Muladhara Chakra. Those who are hit by him are the worst. If you have come near him, be careful. Face yourself, see yourself, note yourself. Another thing they told me, that some people think that they are great Sahaja Yogis who contribute nothing to Sahaja Yoga but headaches. If some saint Sahaja Yogi starts telling the other Sahaja Yogi about something sensible, this fellow puts up his right Vishuddhi, pressing it hard on him to show that you are talking because your Vishuddhi, right Vishuddhi is catching. Very cunning. You are not to play games because you are harming yourself. I am telling you now. Those who think they can play with the loopholes must know that there's a loop round their neck. Like the fallen angels, you'll go to the greater heights or depths of mire. So try to be honest to yourself. Any nation has any problem, any sins they have been committing or have committed before, should not be anymore a tag with you. If a country has been cunning, then you should be innocent. If you are coming from a foxy clan, you have to be innocent. Like you are coming from a thuggery clan, then you have to be extremely astute. If you are coming from the romantic clan, you have to be extremely pure. You have to be juxtaposition of whatever sins we are suffering from. If you are the light in the darkness, you have to be brilliant and not dark. And you have to give light in the darkness to the dark, not to take dark upon yourself. So if you really feel that the past of your country has been such and such, you better study it and know for yourself that you have to be just different. Some are comfort loving, they should get out of that. Some are pleasure loving, they should get out of that. Some are tempted with women and men and drinking and all that, you should completely give up and come out of it. There are deeper sins we have of cunningness, of aggressiveness, of slyness. All these things are to be studied and understood, that what do we have to do for our country is to get out of it completely first of all, like the lotus out of the mire. Then you have to become absolutely a person completely integrated. Like that, you have to be in the juxtaposition to rise higher than the rest of them, to give them a proper lead. I can tell you that Shiva tolerates lot of nonsense because he is fond of forgiving. And Vishnu principle tries to play with them and punish them or kill them. But Ganesh Tattva has no compromise of any kind. And when this becomes Ekadasha Rudra, and when Christ is going to come in that form, then there will be no compromise, no Mataji, no crying, no argument, nothing. Sri Ganesha himself will throw people into hell. So be careful on that. Today, in the presence of Sri Ganesha, you have to take an oath that whatever is the past of my country, I will get opposite to that. Like I would say, Indians are not very good with the money. Money matters, they can be very horrid, and sometimes they create a problem with money matters. So one has to know that we have to be absolutely astute as far as money is concerned. It is not sufficient only to be something innocent, but it is more that it should be proved, that people should know that you are innocent. Like I asked my son-in-law, he's a very honest man, whether this would be honesty. So he answered, this may be honesty for outside purpose, but it is not in the essence of honesty. So that is how you have to be honest in the essence of it. And the essence of honesty is innocence. Essence of sincerity is innocence. Essence of beauty, glory is innocence. And innocence is the one that gives you complete detachment. So to such a symbol of innocence, when we bow, we must know what we have done about ourselves. Whatever has been your past, get out of it. Be just the opposite of what has been so bad before. Strongly against all that you were before in the darkness. That is the sign of your character and of your strength, and will show to the world that your spirit, which is enlightened within you, has given you that strength and that new dimension. So the second oath we have to take before Sri Ganesha is that I will be honest to myself. I will not deceive myself for anybody's sake. Now the third great thing about Sri Ganesha is that for him no gods exist except his mother. And you know all the stories about Sri Ganesha, how he adored his mother. Because he knows his mother is the power, and that he is the source of your wisdom. He is the source of your wisdom.
He is.
He, Sri Ganesh. He is the embodiment of wisdom. And the greatest wisdom he has, that it is better to worship the mother than anybody else, because she is the power. According to him, even the father, if you have to meet, you have to go through the mother. And secondly, father is just the witness. All his security, all his powers, all his beauty, in a sense, comes from his mother. So with the third oath you have to take, that for us, our mother is so powerful, why should we be afraid of anything? If she is going to give us the wisdom, why should we try to seek it anywhere else? I appear very innocent sometimes. But my innocence is complete intelligence, I think. And that is the reason, you see, people take time to accept. But people like Sri Ganesh, who are the wisest of all, know the trick. Another oath we have to take today, that we'll respect every Sahaja Yogi from our heart, because they are made in the form of Sri Ganesh. We'll not make fun of them. We'll not laugh at them. As long as they are in Sahaja Yoga, we have to respect. But they can be thrown away. They can get out of it. But unless and until this happens, do not put your ego on other people. Don't think that you understand everything. Don't think that you know everything. Respect each and every person, not for what he has read or what he has learnt, but because he is a great soul. I feel the whole West suffers from one simple disease, that is, they do not know how to respect anyone. Whatever doesn't suit their mind, they will never accept nor will respect. With their ego, they want to judge everyone and condemn everyone. So get out of it and tell yourself, I don't know anything. I was a stupid fool with my ego. Humble down yourself in your heart. Open your heart and love each other. Respect and love is the two things you have to promise to Sri Ganesha. If you cannot do that, your ascent is going to be very difficult. May God bless you.